It's another big week on the way in the OAMPS Riverina Football League and Farrer League. Joining me at the desk to go through them both is Mitch Cowell, Collie Amberley, coach, and Shane Buchanan from the AFL Riverina. Guys, thanks for joining me.
No worries, Simon.
Thank you.
We'll go to the Riverina Football League first. Taking a look at the ladder, there's a bit of traffic up the top there, Shane.
Yeah, Simon, we might just have a look at the ladder as we go through the show here. And as you see, as it comes up on the screen now, basically we've got the top five teams there on 12 points. We've got Tigers on 8, and then we've got the other three teams there on 4 points. So this round of matches is critical for some of those clubs that, one, to establish themselves in the top five, but also the teams outside the top five to try and stay in touch with those guys as well. So there's some critical games. So really looking forward to this week's matches and seeing where clubs are at, and probably notably Griffith need a win, and also the Tigers.
Excellent. Well, we'll start that off with Griffith up against Manglipar. Griffith, I was pretty impressed with last week, just how well they were able to push Coolerman.
Yeah, like, I mean, all the reports, it was probably one of the best games of footy in local footy for a number of years. So obviously Griffith recruited a couple of players in for that particular match and obviously did really well. Probably had their opportunities to win the game as well. So probably Griffith looked as a missed opportunity, and Coolerman once again got themselves out of a difficult situation with a really good win.
Well, I think that was it. Griffith actually created more scoring opportunities. As a coach, Mitch, how important is it to make the most of those?
Yeah, it's very important. We've struggled with that a little bit this year, kicking more points than goals in every match, I think. So, yeah, you need to really kick them ones, especially every time you go into the 50, you want it only coming out if you've got a goal, really.
Mango coming off the back of the bye. Who's the tip for this one, Shane?
I'm going to go with Mango player. Look, Griffith's recruits, I mean, one in particular, I don't know how committed he's going to be to the club week in, week out. So, look, Mango's been in really good form. They're probably the form team of the competition, I think, at the moment. Had a little hiccup there against Coolum, but I'm going to go with Mango against Griffith.
What about you, Mitch?
Yeah, I'll be with Shane there. I think Griffith done really well pushing Coolum in last week, but I think Mango will be the better team on the day.
Narendra up against the Bulldogs. How do you see this one going, Shane?
Look, Narendra, probably a bit disappointing last week, but I think we mentioned all year they're in a rebuilding stage, there's no doubt about that. Turvey Park had a great win against Wagga Tigers at home. Got a bit of a hoodoo over the Tigers there at Mara over the last couple of years. So I'll go with the Bulldogs over the Eagles in that particular one.
They would be feeling confident after that win. You'd reckon the same as Shane, Mitch?
Yeah, I think Turvey Park will have the better hand there. They'll be coming off a bit of confidence in that, and I think they'll run away with it.
Now, the other team they beat, Wagga Tigers up against Coolerman, going to be a tough challenge for the Tigers.
Oh, I think it might be a tough challenge for Coolerman as well. Yeah, I rate Wagga Tigers. They're a really good team. There's no doubt about that. Probably need to straighten it. They need more goal kickers, a bit like Coolerman, I think, struggling up forward at the moment. If Tigers can find an avenue to go, they'll pressure Coolerman. There's no doubt about that. They're a really good team. It's at home at Wagga Tigers. I think Coolerman, they keep seem to, as I said there before, seem to get these wins on the board in difficult situations. That's a real confidence booster for a club. You know that when you're in a jam, you can get out of it. So I'll go with Coolerman over Tigers in that one.
And I guess that does say a lot about just how close the competition is this year, Mitch.
Yeah, it seems like it's really close. I think Coolerman will edge out Wagga Tigers, but yeah, with Shane, I think there won't be a hell of a lot in there, I don't reckon.
And now the match of the round, got to be Gammain up against Collingully. Really, with this one, any of these could be match of the round, but this one in particular, pretty vital for the ladder.
Yeah, oh, they're sort of built a real rivalry there, and I suppose Shane Lennon's helped that. Been a former Gammain player there. No love lost between the two clubs. Respect each other as well, sort of thing. I suppose in recent weeks, Collingully's form's been really good. They've obviously got some really good young kids that are quick, and if you don't respect them, they'll cut you up. So you need to be on your game, and you need to be pressuring them all the time. Gammain's form's been pretty good as well. Don't worry about that. A good win against Turvey Park, particularly a couple of weeks ago, down at three-quarter time and ran over the top of them. Mitch Steele's been playing really well up forward as well, and Daniel Hitchens kicked 7 goals last week. So, you know, another avenue to go there as well, especially with Jaden Kotzer out with a shoulder injury. Look, that'll be a really tough game, and I reckon it's a toss of the coin, but I might go with Collingully in that particular one.
What do you reckon, Mitch?
Being an ex-Gammain boy, I'd say I'll tip Gammain, but they're obviously a bit smaller this year, but their smaller blokes seem to be stepping up, kicking a few goals. So, yeah, hopefully they can get it through Steely and Hitchie and get their run going and, yeah, hopefully get over the top of them.
Now, moving over to the OAMPS Farrer League, the ladder for this one, it's a very key ladder this round because we've got the two undefeated teams who have been flying along beautifully. Tamora up against Mara. this is probably one of the matches of the year so far.
Yeah, well, once again, so I might quickly just look at the ladder as we can see there on the screen now. We have Tamora and Mara as the standout teams there, and obviously the trendsetters of the competition at the moment. And then we can get to the next bracket of teams where we've got Collie Amley, East Wagga and North Wagga on 8 points, and then we've got the Jets and the Rock on 4. So as you alluded to there, yeah, matches around, we can see that quite easily. But by the same token, those other clubs in the 5, we want to make sure they cement their spot, and critical games for the Jets and the Rock in coming weeks, especially to make sure they keep in touch with the top 5.
Now this one, the Roos and the Bombers, as I said, they've been travelling beautifully, playing some really good footy. Who's going to be the one that comes out on top as the sole leader of the competition?
Well, interesting, isn't it? I mean, this is the match of the year. There's no doubt about that so far in the season. Both undefeated. Tamora had a tough game against Collie last week, no doubt, in wet conditions. So they'll be sore, I would imagine. So as Mitch alluded to before, Collie are a physical team. So no doubt there was some bruised and battered bodies there. Mara had a good win against North Wagga. North Wagga stayed with them, but then probably Mara's class come over the top of them. The news out of Tamora is that they'll have some more inclusions also, with a few more suspended players coming back into vogue, and also some injured players as well. One in particular, I suppose, would be Matt Wallace. I think it's a flip of the coin, Simon. I'm going to go with Tamora, but just because it's at home.
It's very hard to tip against them. You've played both of the sides. What do you make of both of them?
Tamora were good last week. They just finished off a little bit better than us, and yeah, snuck a few goals in, like right on the bell on a couple of quarters. And Mara really ran the ball and carried well. And to be up by 20 points at three quarter time, and they still ran over us, their fitness is obviously great. So I'm going to go for a bit of an upset here and tip Mara by a straight kick.
Excellent. I'm very, very excited for that game. Now, moving down to North Wagga and East Wagga, another key one for these sides, both on 8 points. A win here is obviously going to keep them well in touch with the other top sides.
Yeah, good summary, Simon. There's no doubt about that. They'll need to both looking for a win to make sure that they keep up there with it. They're probably two similar sides as well at where they're at the moment. East Wagga still got their injury concerns with some of their key players, but I'm going to go with East Wagga in that particular match.
What do you think about that one, Mitch?
Yeah, I think East Wagga. I'm not sure if they got Geffert back this week, but he's going to be a big inclusion when he's playing. And they just run and carry the ball well out of the back line. So I think East Wagga will get over the top.
I don't think we need to ask you who you're going to be tipping with Collie Amberley against the Rock. How are you expecting the Rock to be this week?
Yeah, well, they had a win last week, so they'll be full of confidence. And yeah, sort of more of the pressure's on us than the Rock. Like if we drop one game here, and there's a lot on 8 points there, we could go back and be out of the 5. So it's really important for us to get over the Rock and get that extra 4 points to stay up with the top 3 or 4 teams.
What do you reckon about this one, Shane?
I'll go with Collie at home, Simon. I think their form's been pretty good. The Rock obviously got a win last week, but I think Collie's probably travelling a little bit better than the Rock at the moment.
And I don't think it'll be too confusing to tip a winner out of the Jets and CSU. CSU, I was pretty impressed with how they started the game the other week, but again, fell away towards the end, much of the same this week against the Jets.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, Brad be getting his team to go out there and be competitive for 4 quarters. I wouldn't be worrying about the scoreboard. It's about pressuring the opposition, making them earn their kicks in a fair way, and basically trying to be competitive, basically, than worrying about wins. But I think the Jets, they've got a fair bit to play for as well, being 4 points there and just out of the top 5. They'll need a win, and I think they'll get it over the Bush Bigs.
Mitch, if you were coaching CSU, what would the message be to the boys after going out and copying a couple of tough losses to start the season?
Yeah, it'd just be competitive and obviously not going for the win, but maybe just trying to aim to win 1 quarter out of the 4 or something like that, or tie them down to even try and break even in 1 or 2 quarters. But I think the Jets will have them at home.
We'll see how it all goes. Guys, thanks for joining us. Mitch, good luck on the weekend.
Thank you.